By the way, my next book that I'm working on this question of revisiting C. Wright Mills' The Power Elite. And let me just, and I will end on this, so maybe we'll sell three books. Store to pay its rent. Let me just say, in that regard, there are different we's. There are different elites out there, different ways. And there's a war between George Bush and his father. You mentioned the World War.
George Bush.
But George Bush Jr. is betraying the New World Order of his father. Because George Bush Sr., the one, believed in trade. He believed in tourism. He believed in content. He believed in the power of our ideas to influence. It was basically a rejection of the military model, except in extreme situation of the invasion of Kuwait or something. You can argue about it or not. But it was basically a view of where the world is moving now. I happen to disagree with some aspects of it. I think you have to protect the environment. You have to care about labor, you know, wages and so forth that should have been negotiated through the agreements. So I have my criticism of the New World Order. But it was a view that I can at least see is somewhat rational. How we relate to a world in which we will not have dominant power, we will not be able to control the resources. How do you engage with this world, you know, as we see that it's changing? And it was a vision of survival in this world. This young one comes in as a total captive of the neocons. All he wants is a second term to outprove his father and show he's stronger. There's some psychological drama going on. He becomes a captive of these people. I mean, it's you know, Shakespearean. I mean, is that a way to describe it? They're plotting in the palace and stabbing other people in the Colonial Palace and so forth. They grab power. And the sad thing is, it's not a historical drama. It's the most important, by far, country in the whole world. And it's in the hands of quite dangerous people. And now, there are other people in this society who run big businesses. Like, for instance, if I ran a big oil company or a big international, multinational company, I would think these people are the worst thing going. Yes, it's true. Some companies, imperialism does not pay. Some companies, a very old-fashioned model, some companies make out like bandits, like Halliburton and Bechtel and so forth. Some individuals make out very well. Most of the taxpayers don't make out well. Most of the businesses don't make out well. Because imagine trying to do business in most of the world. You're afraid to even be a tourist in much of the world because you're an American. You know, imagine trying to make contracts and long-term contracts and do business and so forth. Meanwhile, what's happening? It's interesting. Let me conclude on this. The Chinese, let's take that model. The Chi-Coms. They were supposed to take us over with their guns. There was even the big scandal of Wen Houli and stealing the nuclear, the big phony thing, which the New York Times, by the way, played a bad role in, which I wrote a lot about. Okay, Chinese aren't doing that. Has anyone noticed the price of oil is way up there? The Chinese have hardly any oil. They're making out like bandits. Why? Because they're producing this stuff and they're making all these contracts all over. And while we're putzing around in Iraq, the Chinese are going from Australia to Iran, and they're signing up raw material contracts for the next 50 years. And they're taking care of business. They're the new capitalists. They're the new enlightened capitalists, you know, in Israel and the Indians from a different ideological base are going to do the same, you know, and this is the model. We've got these yokels here who are playing with a very old-fashioned model that didn't work. And ironically, remember, it's funny because this comedian, I didn't go to this magic show, but my son got in an argument with the guy, he's a good magician, I've been there before, but about the French, because he was making anti-French jokes. And my son, who's one of the editors, challenged him on it. So anyway, think about it. Everybody says, oh, the problem with the Germans and the French, they don't like to fight. They only believe in retreat. They're the Germans, they have the DNA of pacifists or something. or the French. This is what the guy said last night, the French. They just, oh, bullshit. Well, wait a minute. These are the two of the great imperial powers. These are people quite willing to slaughter and be slaughtered and the whole thing, you know. They learned, just as the majority of people in England, I mean, not their government, but the majority of people, just like the majority of people in Spain learned, in Italy learned, you know, imperialism does not pay. Now, that's a long-winded answer to your question. That's why I think we have a chance. This is not good for business. It's not good for Republicans. You know, this is not good for the society, this kind of policy. It is incredibly destructive. And they, you know, if you look at what Gates, did you read the, I don't know if you have the used book version of Gates and Buffett's Defense of the Inheritance Tax?
No.
Okay. But if you look at what Buffett's been saying, Gates Sr. and even Gates, Bill Gates and so on, you look at some of this enlightened Soros, some of the enlightened capitalists we have in our society, Ned Lamont is a perfect example. Ned Lamont is a big capitalist. Guy who just won in Connecticut. Read the piece he had in the Wall Street Journal yesterday. He said, I am coming out of my business experience, and I know this Iraq war is a disaster. And you don't stay the course when the course takes you off the cliff. That's what that's in his Wall Street Journal piece yesterday. You don't stay the course. That is not good business sense. So I think in the end, if they don't throw us in camps or something, we will win because we do have logic and facts on our side. And let me end on that.
And when even Bill Buckley is using
folks, if you could stack a chair when you get up in this test, there are two different types of chairs. Oh, yes, well, we're just going to make room. We're just going to make room. And come on back to the back of the paper book and come on up here, and Robert will sign for it.
So, it's a little hard, so it's a little bit of a